Cedar Key's a step away from reality most times, but today, the usually relaxed island is on edge.
It's the storm surge, I think, that's the real big worry here.
2 years ago, Hurricane Hermine brought storm surge more than 7 feet high on parts of the island. Second Street isn't on the water, but during Hurricane Hermine, it was underwater.
3 feet of water everywhere, 4 feet. Not a lot of wind, but lots of water.
Here's what one of those businesses looks like right now. Here's what it looked like after Hurricane Hermine's storm surge.
Hopefully it won't be as bad as Hermine, but they're saying it might be worse.
Hurricane Michael's winds are forecasted to push this water upwards and inland. And since Cedar Key is so vulnerable to storm surge like we saw in Hurricane Hermine, businesses, especially over the water, are very concerned.
We're getting the wind that's boarded up and getting everything ready just in case.
As some border up, Duncan's on the Gulf is trying a different approach.
We're going to embrace the water that's coming, and we're going to leave the doors and windows open. Hopefully it won't break them, you know, if we accept the water.
The bar area sits on pilings that hold the floor just a few feet above the Gulf of Mexico.
We're bringing everything upstairs to secure the bar as much as we can. Our equipment, our tables, our chairs, basically nothing stays.
Owner Laura Duncan has been on Cedar Key for less than a year, but is experienced with hurricanes.
We survived Andrew in the Florida Keys, and then Irma that devastated our restaurant, Marker 8.5, in the little town of Goodland. And again, here we find ourselves getting ready for another hurricane.
They've shared the positive Cedar Key experiences they've had so far and are hoping for the best, but preparing for the worst along with everyone along the northern Gulf Coast of Florida. In Cedar Key, Alex Calamia, TV 20 News.